Hello students, today we are going to study a new poem, Indian Weavers, written by Sarojini Naidu. Now let us try to know about the poet. First of all, Sarojini Naidu was born in 1879 and she died in 1949. So she was born as Sarojini Chattopadhyay in Hyderabad. She is also known as the Nightingale of India and was an Indian independence activist and poet. She served as the first governor of the United Provinces of Agra and Awadh from 1947 to 1949. Sarojini Naidu was the first woman to become the governor of an Indian state and was the second woman to become the president of the Indian National Congress. Now let us have the introduction of the poem Indian Weavers. Indian Weavers by Sarojini Naidu is a short poem consisting of three stanzas having four lines each. The poet talks about three types of dresses that the Indian weavers weave at three particular times of the day. Metaphorically, each time and the dress weaved in that time symbolizes a particular stage of life. The poet uses a number of literary devices to express her ideas like simile, metaphor, etc. The poem also consists of a discussion between the poet and the weavers. The poet asks the weavers and the latter reply. Now let us have the explanations of the stanzas. Now stanza number one. Weavers weaving at break of day, why do you weave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of the hills in wild, we weave the robes of a newborn child. So dear students, here weavers, the people who weave a particular garment. Break of day means early in the morning. Garment means your cloth. Gay means happy. And what kind of cloth they are weaving? So even the weavers reply. Now let us have the explanation of the above lines, above stanza. In the first stanza, the poet questions the weavers that why are they weaving clothes early in the morning? That seems to be quite beautiful and charming and of a particular color. The poet is curious to know about these clothes as they seem quite special. The weavers reply that the clothes that they are weaving are blue as the wing of a halcyon, particular bird. Okay, so which is the other name of the kingfisher whose wings are bright blue in color? The weavers reply that they are weaving the robes of a newborn child who has just come to the world. This stanza describes the first stage of human life, which is full of freshness, happiness, beauty, and hope, and there is no place for sorrow at this stage. Now, let us have second stanza. Weavers weaving at fall of night, why do you weave a garment so bright like the plumes of peacock purple and green? We weave the marriage veils of a queen. Veils means a cover. Okay, in this stanza the poet meets the Indian weavers again during the fall of night and asks why they are weaving a cloth late in the evening, which is the time when the most of the Indian marriages take place. She also asks, she means here the poet, Sarojini Naidu, asks why they are weaving a garment so bright like the plumes, feathers. of a peacock, purple and green. The weavers reply that the cloth is bright and richly colored because they are wearing it for a queen. They are weaving it for a queen. She will use it to make her marriage veil. This stanza describes the second or adult stage of life when humans quest for a better and prosperous life. The colors purple and green symbolize the ups and downs of the life that makes adulthood bright. Now let us have stanza number 3. Weavers weaving solemn and still. Solemn means very serious, still means peacefully. What do you weave in the moonlight chill? White as feather and white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. In the final stanza, the poet finds the weavers quite sorrowful, grieved and silent. Grieved means sorrowful. They are weaving something weird in the dead of the night, which is colorless and lifeless. So rather than asking why are they weaving, she asks what are they weaving. The weavers reply that they are weaving shroud, which means a cloth used to put on the dead body. This represents the final stage of human life, that is death, which is lifeless and emotionless, just like a white cloud or a feather. However, the white color also symbolizes eternal peace and calm that comes with death. The poem sums up human life in 3 main stages. Using symbols like clothes and times of the day, the life starts its journey with blue color, representing joy and happiness, and then come green and purple that represent the ups and downs of life along with happiness, and finally comes a single color, white, that represents the last stage of human life when the person dies, and with him the emotions that were connected to life die as well. So hopefully students, I think you have got all the stanzas clear in your mind. Even let us have the summary. Indian Weaver sums up the life of human beings on earth in 3 main stages by using symbol like clothes and times of the day. The journey of life begins with one color, blue, which means joy and happiness. It continues with the addition of a number of colors, green and purple, which means sorrows, also enter into life along with happiness. Life is more active in this stage than in the first stage. In the final stanza, all the colors vanish away and a single color, white, remains, which means emotions are connected with life, and when the person dies, emotions also die with him. Now let us talk of the theme of the poem. The central theme of the poem is the parallelism that the poet beautifully draws between the 3 parts of the weaver's workday and the 3 stages of human life. What is the mood of the poem? The words are gay, bright, solemn and still in the poem indicate the changing mood of the poem. Now let us talk of literary devices. It means poetic beauty or the figures of speech. Literary or poetic device is a technique a writer or poet uses to produce a special effect in their writing. They are, number 1, simile. A figure of speech involving the comparison of one thing with another thing of a different kind used to make a description more emphatic or vivid. Vivid means clear. Example is here, as brave as a lion. The use of similes as a method of comparison, use of words as and like are example of the same. So here simile has been used. Next, metaphor. a word or phrase that is used in an imaginative way to show that somebody or something has the same qualities as another thing. Here, example is break of day to compare it to childhood. Next, personification has been used. So, personification is a poetic device in which a thing or an idea is given human attributes. Alliteration means letters of alphabet. It is a stylistic device in which a number of words having the same first consonant sound occur close together in a series. Example, alliteration and repetitive consonant sounds of V throughout the stanzas, or P in purple peacock, and repetition of the words weavers weaving and weave across the poem are the examples of metaphor also. Next is imagery. Imagery is the name given to the elements in a poem that spark off the senses. So despite image being a synonym for picture, images need not be only visual. Any of the five senses, sight, hearing, touch, taste, smell, can respond to what a poet writes. Example is here. The poet has painted the picture of Indian weavers who weaves tirelessly at different times of a day. This poem has been used as an imagery to describe the three stages of human life from birth to death, just as the weavers weave from dawn to night. Next, rhyming scheme. The rhyme scheme of the poem is A A B B C C D D E E F F.